Hello and welcome to Coffee with Carey. It's cold already. What can I tell you? Thank you for stopping by today. I appreciate you being here. If you're new, I'm Carey. This is my channel for women over 50, but everyone's welcome. Why not? We've got a lot of men who stop by, and some of you are between 25 and 35, according to my analytics, and you're all welcome. Dating advice applies to everybody, really. Sometimes we talk very specifically about things that are applicable to women in their 50s like me, but often it's something like, are you picking projects? Are you constantly finding yourself starting to date somebody who's a fixer-upper? If that's your problem, something you're prone to doing, you'll want to stick around because that's what we're talking about today. First of all, I wanted to point out that if you are a person who is drawn to fixer-uppers and you're constantly trying to change somebody or mold them into somebody better, that usually that means that you have some really fine qualities, which is that you care about other people, you're willing to give of yourself, and that you want what's best for other people. But if you find that you're doing this over and over again, what you will understand eventually is that you're wasting your time because people don't change unless they want to, and you're keeping yourself from meeting somebody who's great for you. So that's point number one. You've got to be available for the right person, and if you keep picking the wrong person, the right ones keep walking by and you're not noticing because you're busy fixing somebody. Next, I wanted to point out that everybody would love to have someone who is supportive and a cheerleader for them. It's when you're trying to fix somebody who doesn't necessarily realize that they have a problem and didn't ask for your help in the first place. So, of course, encourage someone you care about. Wanting somebody to grow is a great thing, especially if they want to grow also, or they've asked, I really want to change this habit, can you help me? But I guess the question really is, was this their idea or was it yours? If it's something this person wants to work on and they think it's a good idea, then by all means, be supportive. Be that cheerleader. But everybody deserves to be loved for who they are. You wouldn't want somebody to want to be with you based on your potential or who they think you could be if only you would change these three things about yourself. So be fair and make sure you're on the same page. And then the next point was, what exactly are we trying to change? Are we just trying to get somebody to wear clothes that match? Is this a wardrobe overhaul, or are we trying to get somebody to have a sense of humor? Because there's a big difference between those two, and with one of them, you'll have a lot of luck. You just go shopping with somebody or bring home clothes for them. There have been a couple of men in my life that enjoyed me picking out things that I liked, and they were happy to wear them, and that's great. But if you're trying to change somebody and give them more ambition, you're probably a fixer, and you're trying to change this person into somebody they're not. You really can't change integral parts of somebody's personality, no matter how much time you invest and how hard you try, or how much you wish they would, because then they would be perfect. You're probably better off looking for somebody who already has that ambition, already has that sense of humor, and you'll get a better outcome if that person comes equipped with those qualities, as opposed to trying to fit somebody into a mold that you think would be ideal. I mean, if you think about it, you wouldn't like if somebody was doing that to you and trying to change parts of your personality or give you qualities that you don't really think are important. So, does this person want to change, and how do you know? Well, ask them. If you're getting responses like, well, nobody's perfect, then you kind of know that they're not up for the change and on the same page. And really, your time is one of your most precious commodities. So don't waste your time on something that isn't going to work out in the long run. You're better off finding a hobby that you truly enjoy that will have a positive impact on your life and not a negative impact on somebody else's. And really, all of this, even if you were to change a person, you know where that leads? It really leads to resentment. And oddly enough, not just resentment from the person who's made these changes to accommodate you, but for some reason, when women change men, they end up resenting them for allowing themselves to be changed, which is really a weird little dichotomy, isn't it? So I think the key here is to do unto others, you know, the golden rule, do unto others, as you would have them do unto you, which means treat other people the way you want to be treated, and knowing that you wouldn't want somebody overhauling your personality and all your traits that you've worked so hard to make a personality out of, then just don't do that to somebody else. Let them go, that let them find somebody who will appreciate them just the way they are, and not constantly be in that battle of trying to change them and fit that square peg into the round hole. It's better for everybody involved, honestly. Two more points, and the next one is a little psychology, which would tell you that if you are trying to change somebody, then probably you may need some changing. It's you who may need to do some accepting as opposed to trying to change another person. Maybe it's your tolerance, or maybe it's just acceptance in general. But they say that you should examine yourself when you are trying to change other people. I don't know what the issue would be with you. Not even any example is coming to mind, but it is definitely something worth exploring. And then finally, I wanted to end with a quote that I throw around quite a bit, and I've actually never memorized it, so I'm going to read it to you. I'm always paraphrasing, but I want to get it right for you, and it is this. Consider how hard it is to change yourself, and you'll understand what little chance you have. I think it says in changing someone else, it's cut off. You get the point. Hard to make changes to yourself. If the person isn't doing it for themselves, they're doing it for another person, it's not going to last. And you stand very little chance in making a long-lasting change in another person. So value your own time. Value that other person. Let them go to somebody who can be a great cheerleader for all their qualities that they do have. And find somebody who ended up being made just the way you would want somebody who you're going to spend your life with. Somebody who has all those things on your list. Don't make a big list, but those major qualities that you enjoy in another human, that you appreciate, that you also have, that are important to you, that you're proud of in yourself, and find those in another person, then you're on the right track and things are gonna go a lot smoothly. I hope you found this helpful, and if you did, please give the episode a thumbs up. And if you would subscribe, that would be great. We get to hang out again soon. And if we want to make sure that happens, hit that ring bell and then you're notified every time I upload a new episode. I'll look forward to seeing you back soon. And until then, have a good one. But the quote goes something like this. And the quote goes something like this.